following presentation is for mature audiences only.
Who are you?
He's a fine man.
All hell is broken loose.
He's a great broadcaster.
He's a very powerful guy.
Absolutely brilliant.
Feared by men, adored by women.
He's a smart boy.
It's patriotic.
It's no big deal.
It's the end of the world.
I might as well tell you now. He's a monkey.
And how you doing, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages? Welcome in to another edition of The Wild Side with Eric Clark. I am your not-at-all-humble host, Eric Clark, saying thank you for taking time out of your busy day to give my video a watch and a listen. If you like it, like it. If you think other people are going to like it, give it a share. Make sure you're subscribed to the YouTube channel and you're following me on all the social media platforms. That way, if there's a song, a band, a video, something you want me to check out, you can leave it in the comment section below or hit me up with a DM. If you are going to leave it in the comments below, just read through. If somebody's already made your suggestion, leave a like and an I concur. That'll help me put things in the handy-dandy notebook. I want to say thank you to Aspen Dental, Connect 200, and Music to See. They are those that power The Wild Side with Eric Clark. Today's suggestion is coming from social media. I had done a breakdown and a review of Gary Moore, and somebody had suggested I do the other awesome Irish guitarist. Ireland cranked out two of the greatest progressive blues guitarists in the history of rock and roll with Gary Moore and Rory Gallagher. In 1973, Rory Gallagher released an album called Tattoo containing a song called Cradle Rock. And then he went out on tour, and in 1970 tour, he played Belfast. And I believe the story goes, I think the day before the concert, there were some troubles in Belfast, and everyone thought he was going to cancel, and he went ahead and did the show anyway. Rory Gallagher hated playing in a studio. He much preferred to play live. He felt like he got the best energy and he was able to perform better if he could see people sitting in front of him. So a filmmaker went and was just going to film like a promotional video, but it ended up the film being so good that it was released as a film. It was the Irish tour from 1974. Today we're checking out the opening of that show. This is how this guy opened the show. And I can sit here and tell you all about Rory Gallagher and the influences and his contemporaries and who he is up there ranked with, like Mike Bloomfield, Peter Green, Jimi Hendrix, Terry Kath, Eric Clapton, Billy Gibbons. But I'll let him explain to you exactly why people hold him in such high regard. Rory Gallagher, Cradle Rock, live 1974 in Belfast. Let's check it out. Now I'm going to stop it real here because he's going to get into some really cool stuff and I want to let that roll. But I got to tell you, this is everything you hear like after 1975 is coming from this. You're hearing what you heard in Peter Green's Fleetwood Mac. You're hearing what you heard in early Robin Trower, in early Them with Van Morrison, early progressive blues-based rock. You're hearing the source of it right here. This guy is an absolute legend, and what you're getting ready to see him do with this guitar, no one else can do.
It's all about me and you.
Okay, I want to pause here in the break real quick before he gets back into it, because a lot of the critics at the time didn't think that the band backing Rory Gallagher was that good. I think the word that was used was pedestrian. And while he's out here just absolutely killing it, I really need you to pay attention to the absolute groove pocket that these musicians are creating for Rory Gallagher here. And most importantly, the drummer Rod DeArth. I hope I got that right. This guy is creating such a ferocious pocket that these guys are weaving in and out of, that to call them pedestrian, I'd like to know the people's names so I can be like, dude, this is not pedestrian.
If I was a deaf man, give me ears to hear. If I was an amen, give me new legs to walk. If you were really truly my bed, this is what I talk.
Gallagher. No relation.
If I was a brother, then you let me roll. If I was a pony, then you let me try. If I was the answer, then you get the free. But when I want to see you, babe, you put your dog on me.
Rory Gallagher, 1974, with Cradle Rock from the Irish Tour, 74. And, dude, that right there, that was a performance very reminiscent to me when it comes to the energy, when it comes to the proficiency of groove that these musicians are in right here. Not just Rory Gallagher. Rory Gallagher is a legend. And that right there is an example of the absolute control and mastery of his instrument that he has. But it was very reminiscent of Alvin Lee and 10 years after doing I'm Going Home at Woodstock, to where they're so into it that no one outside of the immediate arena or viewing area, whatever you want to call it, this is one of those momentary performances, meaning the moment captured on film, captured on tape, really will never be able to translate the energy and the vibe that was coming through. It's almost like tape can't really contain the greatness of Rory Gallagher and that band. So, like I said before, when he released some albums, I think it was Tattoo and the one prior to that, I think there were a couple of critics who came out and said that these backing members, Jerry McAvoy, Lou Martin, and Rod DeArth, called them pedestrian, called them a backing band, called them pedestrian. But when you see a performance like this, you're hearing the keyboard, you're hearing the bass, and you're hearing the drums all come together in this furious, beautiful groove that Rory Gallagher is able to weave, this absolutely traditional progressive blues sound. That is right there with Peter Green's Fleetwood Mac Oh Well. It's right there with Mike Bloomfield. This is just a perfect example of why Rory Gallagher is a legend. He's manipulating that guitar, and there's a point in this video when he's manipulating the slide. And just like Dwayne Allman was able to do, and just like the influence that came from Dwayne Allman, you're hearing it, but ratchet it up a bit. So when you're watching him play that slide, go back and watch that video and really focus on his hands while he's playing that slide at about 2:45, 3 minutes. You can see him. He has such control of this fretboard, and he has such control of this instrument that he's able to just barely rock that slide tube up and down those strings to create such a distinctive tone. When you talk about people like Billy Gibbons, you hear things like the dirty G. The dirty G is a chord that is very distinctive tone to Billy Gibbons. And Rory Gallagher's library in general is a specific tone to his greatness. It's a shame that we lost him in 1994, I believe at the age of 47, to a staph infection that led from something else. He wasn't feeling well. Something led, very tragic. But this is one of those great examples, this live version. And he kicked off the show with that. It's a great example of how a singular musician can establish such a massive tone that the tone carries through for generations to come. That tone that you're hearing coming from Rory Gallagher came through in the Stone Roses. It came through in Oasis. It came through everybody that picked up a guitar from that point forward. That's how influential he was. And you need to know who that was. So I want to thank my buddy on Twitter, I believe, who sent me the DM saying, hey, you need to do a reaction to Rory Gallagher. There you go. 1974, the Irish tour, that is Cradle Rock. The studio version is from the album Tattoo, but I actually believe that is the better version, regardless of the vocals on the microphone. That was a fantastic performance, and you should have that in your library. So thank you very much for the suggestion. Again, if you have a suggestion for a band, a song, a video, something you want me to check out, you can leave it in the comment section below or hit me up with a DM. But again, if you're going to leave a suggestion, just go through. If somebody else has made that suggestion, just leave a like in and I concur. I can get it in the handy-dandy notebook. Thank you to Aspen Dental, Connect 200, and Music to See. They are those that power the wild side with Eric Clark. Make sure you're looking out for each other. Make sure you're looking out for your neighbor. Try to do at least one good thing a day. I am Eric Clark, and this has been The Wild Side.